Let's talk about how we can solve the equation x squared plus 9 is equal to 0, and we should get two approaches for this. First, because we just have the x squared term right here, we can move the 9 to the other side, and we get x squared equals negative 9. Then, to get rid of the square, we can just go ahead and take the square root both sides. Then, remember, we have to put a plus or minus on the right-hand side with the number. This way, the square and the square root cancel, and we just get x is equal to plus or minus. And now you might be wondering, can we really have a negative inside of the square root? Well, not in the real world. So if you want to say this equation has no real solution, that's totally okay. Or if you're willing to use imaginary number, then you can continue like so. Have a look. When we have a negative inside of the square root, we can use the imaginary unit I, okay? And then let's just go ahead and do square root of 9, which is just a regular 3. So the answers are plus or minus 3i, and then we are done. Now, what we did right here is that we used the following. Note that I is the imaginary unit, so that I squared gives you negative 1. So we define this to be like so, and you can look at this as square root of negative 1 gives you the I, and that's exactly what we did. Now, let me show you guys another way. Especially, I want to explain why whenever we take the square root both sides, we really have the plus or minus. Let's have a look. X squared plus 9 equal to 0. We can do this by factoring. How? Difference of two squares. But this is a plus. Don't worry, let me show you. I'm going to look at this as x squared, but for the plus, I'll look at this as a minus, and then minus. Minus plus minus gives us a plus. Yeah. And then, of course, we still have the 9 right here. That's equal to 0. Okay, we have a difference. This right here is, of course, a square, right? X squared. Now the question is, what squared will give us negative 9? Well, we know 3 squared will give us 9, but how can we get a negative though? Well, the answer is this right here. I squared gives us negative 1. So if I also put in I right here, I squared will give us the negative 1 that we need. And that is, of course, equal to 0. Then we can factor it by using the difference of two square formula, which is x minus 3i, right? This minus that, times x plus 3i. So you can see that we have two factors. We are going to set the first factor equal to 0. Likewise, the second factor equal to 0. Move this to the other side. First answer, x equals 3i. Second answer, move this to the other side, x equals negative 3i. Together, we can put it as x equals plus or minus 3i. Or if you would like, you can also write it separately to emphasize that there are indeed two different solutions. So that's it. And if you want to see more equations like this, check out this video. Especially, you can see how to get four solutions for that particular one.